And good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to another edition of Earl Farrell for Memphis. And we're starting off today with something I think you're really going to enjoy. It's an iconic restaurant here in Memphis. And it's all these segments of my favorite restaurant are brought to you by Southern Security, which is a credit union, not a bank. And they wanted to do something to help restaurants, and they came on board and said, let's get as many restaurants on as we possibly can and go everywhere. And that's what we've been doing. But Southern Security Federal Credit Union, they've got 5 locations. It's not a bank, it's a credit union, but they do everything a bank can do. And you're a member, so you're not treated like a number, you're treated like one of the owners. And so I want to thank them for sponsoring this segment. And really, we've brought you so many great restaurants, and we're going to continue to do that. So thank you once again to Southern Security Federal Credit Union. And now we're going to check back in with Jerry and get him on camera. So stand by and save that. And here we go. And there's Mr. Jerry Colletti himself. Good afternoon, sir.
Hi, Earl. How are you today?
I'm doing great. Everybody I've told we were going there, everybody goes, I love that place. In fact, I put on the promo that Ron Olson brought his prom date there when he was in high school down in Whitehaven. And he said he brought her on the bus. I said, I don't know if I believe that part of the story, but he did. He did confirm that he did come to. He said that was the place to go, you know, and it still is for so many people.
Ron was one of our best customers for the barbecue pizza. He loved the barbecue pizza.
Still does. I mean, and that's the thing. You know, I was in there the other day at lunchtime. Some guy came in, got his whole office barbecue pizza, and there must have been 15 pizzas there. And he's still cranking them out.
Oh, yeah. We sell a lot of barbecue pizzas. So.
Tell us a little bit about the history. I know you're standing outside right now, and it's...
Well, I would start outside the building here. And then go inside.
Okay.
Well, the history, my granddad started this place back in 1923. So in about 2.5 years, we'll be celebrating our 100th anniversary.
Wow.
And we're quite proud of that fact. We are the oldest continuously operating restaurant in Memphis.
I was going to ask if that was the case.
The arcade is actually a little older, but they closed down for 6 months, and they did change hands. But we've never closed and never changed hands. So we lay claim to the oldest continuously operating restaurant.
Now well, there was a fire at this location, or are you at another location?
No, we used to have a restaurant on Summer Avenue.
Okay.
And in 1996, the fire completely demolished that whole restaurant.
Well, I remember there's actually a newspaper article inside, and it talks about the fire.
It is, and I'm going to take you in and show you that. I just wanted to show you the outside of the building here for a second, so some people may recognize it.
Oh, I think they will. You're located right there at South Parkway and the Midtown Expressway, I-55, it's 40 or... I don't know. I call it the Midtown Expressway, and this is the lobby where you come in and sit down. Right now, I noticed you had no more than 3 people in the lobby at a time.
Yeah. What did I do?
You're good.
I'm showing you this article on the fire. I don't know if.
We can see it. Very good. And he said you would rebuild. How long did it take you to get back up and running?
Well, you know, we tried to rebuild on the same location, but the building codes wouldn't quite let us do that because we only had 1/2 acre of land, and they said we could only build a 50-seat restaurant. So we bought some land on Appling Road. It's 1.5 acres, and we have about a 200-seat restaurant on Appling Road, which my 3 children run.
Sure. And you're really so far away that it doesn't impact either one. You've got your customers, but so many people love coming to yours just because it takes them right back to where they were when they were coming there in high school. Their parents brought them there. And now you've had, what, 4 or 5 generations have come through there.
We have people, I have people come in all the time around and say, you know, I hadn't been here in 40 years.
We say, you need to come back a little more often.
Yeah, that's what I tell them. I said, no, don't wait another 40 years before you come back. But yeah, we have a lot of customers that, you know, well, they move out of town or they move here and there, and then they come back and they want to come back to where, a place that they recognize that, that's still in business.
Take us and show us the dining room, and this will be a flashback for a lot of people making and turning that corner.
And, a few Christmas decorations.
Oh yeah, and you had your team Christmas party last night for everybody that works at the restaurant. How did that go?
We did. It went well. We all had a good time and had a few little drinks and got the feeling good. So that would, but we didn't have too much.
No, never too much. And I see you've got another Christmas tree further down in there, and you've got everybody spaced out.
What we call the Blue Room. This dining room was built in the 70s, and it's supposed to. I wonder if I can get a better.
There you go.
It's supposed to resemble an outdoor courtyard with
stars.
You can see the sky and the stars.
Oh,
in the
sky. That is gorgeous. I've always eaten in the room before you get there. I didn't know the Blue Room was there.
And we call this the Blue Room, I guess because of the sky.
Oh, that's gorgeous. Hey, would you ever have thought
then that... the other dining room...
Yeah, this is where I always eat, is in this one. In fact, the last time I was there was... gosh, about a year ago, man, that's exactly where we sat. Came in for lunch one day.
Yeah, well, this is the oldest dining room. We do most of our serving in this room. And then if I turn the corner here, going into the other dining room, and then I want to show you what our Elvis room.
Now, there's a story, I want you to see if you'll confirm this or not, that Elvis used to come in there on, I don't know, every once in a while, and they would have play poker with his guys and you, and after you closed at night and played poker for a long time. And he said that one night Jerry Lee pulled up out front in his limo and that sent somebody up the door to see if they could come in and get a pizza. And you asked Elvis if he wanted to let him in, and he said, "No, I'll make him wait in the limo. Tell him you'll bring it out." He said, "Any truth to that story, Jerry?"
Well, no, not really. Jerry did come, but I don't think he wanted to get out of the car. He didn't want to stay in his car.
Well, that's probably that story has probably been enhanced by Ron Olson. He always takes a good story and makes it more interesting. So.
Yeah.
So is it back there behind where Elvis is standing?
This is this is the room where Elvis used to eat, and he used to sit right there in front of me at the, facing the camera here.
So he'd always sit right there in the middle?
Right, yeah, in the middle, and Priscilla would sit beside him. And
what was his favorite thing to eat there?
Well, Elvis liked the barbecue pizza.
Yeah.
Now these Elvis montage of pictures here. Of course, that was put up. While Elvis was alive.
Not while he's alive, but because he was there, you didn't need pictures of him.
No.
How was he? Was he always a? Because everything, and I've interviewed thousands of people. And not one person has ever said anything, but he was always just as friendly and nice as he could possibly be.
Well, he was. And to give you an example of that, George Klein brought him in this one particular night. And I remember it was on a Sunday night because I was in the lobby on duty. And he wanted Elvis to try the ravioli. Well, back in those days, we didn't have a ravioli machine, and we had a lady that made them by hand, and she could only make like 50, I don't know, she made 50, 60 dozen a day. Anyway, when Elvis came in and ordered ravioli, we were out. Well, that was quite embarrassing. But Elvis didn't get the least bit upset. He said, told the waitress to bring him a plate of spaghetti. And that tells you a lot about a person. He didn't get upset at all. George got a little bit upset, and Elvis didn't.
he said probably sold him because he said, you know how much you love that ravioli. And George is another one who was a dear friend.
And not as an extension of that, it wasn't not long after that, I guess because of that incident, that my dad bought a ravioli machine.
That's not going to happen again.
No, it makes 20 dozen a minute.
Wow.
Once you load the hoppers with the meat. So at Christmas time, our ravioli sales really doubled.
I saw a sign in there that you're taking orders for now for the ravioli and gravy. And so you want to give out your phone number so people can start dialing right now?
Well, sure. Our 948-7652.
Go ahead and get a barbecue pizza tonight, and you'll come by and pick it up. Who's that signed by?
This is a menu I'm showing you. Priscilla signed it. She was in about a year ago. I don't know if you can see her signature or not, but she's standing there with my wife.
Yeah, there she is. I've gotten to meet her several times. She's a very nice lady.
She's very nice. She said, what a pleasure to come back and eat the same and the food tastes exactly the same. As you know, we loved your food, Priscilla.
And that is a thing. When they talk about food being a comfort thing, it is. When you can eat something and you remember the people you ate it with before and the times you had before, that's why people keep coming back there.
And then also we have a menu signed by Lisa Marie.
Wow. And she came there as a little girl.
Well, no, she didn't. Actually, she's never been here, but my son was her personal chef when she come to town, and he got her to sign a menu for us. She's had our food many times, but
just
she's never
been in. Well, that's amazing. And take us back to the kitchen. Let's show us some of the food. There's some folks dining in there.
Okay.
And have you been able to hang on to most of your people throughout all this, Jerry?
Well, you know, we've had a few. In fact, I had the virus, too, back in September.
Oh, wow.
For 2 weeks, I just sat at home in my easy chair and couldn't do anything. But I recovered, and I'm fine now.
But you never had to go to the hospital or anything? You just isolated?
No, I had any trouble breathing or anything.
Well, God bless you.
Zero energy. And zero appetite. I lost 11 pounds, so something could come out of it.
I had a hip replacement this summer, and I had the same thing. I got out. I just didn't have an appetite, and I lost about 25 pounds. So I said, hey, a little good with the bad there.
Let's see.
Just tap that little
icon. Let's look at the bar while we're here.
Okay, yeah.
This is the bar area where...
Now, you like other bars, you can't have anybody saddle up to the bar, but you can be in the bar at a table.
But the health department won't let us have anybody sitting at the bar.
Right.
We're at 50% capacity in here also, just like we are in the dining room.
Sure.
But
there have been a lot of folks that have been at that bar over the years, and there's your extensive wine selection.
We have a nice wine display here in the lobby. And
there's the world famous kitchen right there.
Going into the kitchen. I hope we can get one coming out.
So how many pizzas can you crank out of there, Jerry?
Well,
there's one that looks like you just brought out of the oven.
Yeah, that's one that just came out of the oven. That looks like a
the most popular
seller is around the world.
Yeah.
And this is it right here. It's got, go ahead and pop it. It's got sausage and beef and mushrooms and shrimp. And after they cut it, they put on peppers and pepperoni.
Oh, you're killing me, man. that looks delicious.
Popular pizza.
That looks fabulous.
Now, we also sell a lot of pepperoni. This is a pepperoni pizza that just came out.
Oh, man.
so it's just ready to be cut up.
And I guess
Pearl is our most popular. We probably sell more of these than anything. And barbecue is our second best seller.
Boy, look at that. That
is probably third.
That is a spectacular pizza there.
That's the Ring of the World pizza, and we sell a lot of those.
I can see why. It looks delicious. Of course, your pasta, your spaghetti and meat, I mean, those are all the traditional dishes that you sell there.
Here. This is linguine.
Ooh, wow.
Fredo. Can you see it okay?
Yes, it looks great. You're in tight, and you can see the light glistening off it.
This is simply spaghetti and with meat sauce on it.
Man, that... I can hear the phones dialing even as we speak. that looks fabulous.
Oh, here comes barbecue pizza coming out.
Oh, there it is. That's the one that the Elvis loved.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what, it all looks great, and I know it tastes great. You don't stay in business almost 100 years if you're not doing everything right. And that's a lot of peppers in that barrel right there. My daughter could go through that in about a week, I think. She loves those peppers. But
story behind the barbecue pizza, if you'd like to hear it.
Sure, go ahead.
Back in the early 50s, my dad was running the place, and he had sailors to Millington coming in asking for pizza. Well, he decided to put pizza on the menu, which he did, but it wasn't going over very well because back in the 50s, only Chicago and New York had pizza, and in Memphis, nobody knew what pizza was.
Yeah, I was out in West Texas. I'd never heard of a pizza before.
And anyway, it was, he came up with the idea of the barbecue pizza to stimulate interest in pizza, because here in Memphis, everybody knows what barbecue is. And sure enough, it sparked interest in pizza, and the barbecue pizza remains our signature item today.
Well, and other people have kind of taken it and done barbecue spaghetti. I know that the barbecue shop does that. Do y'all do barbecue spaghetti?
We don't do that. We leave that to them.
Yeah, there you go. You keep your secret, they keep their secret.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, Jerry, I tell you what, we love you. We love your restaurant, and I'm glad you're still there and plan on being there a lot longer, and encourage everybody to go by and support Coletta's, both locations, one out off Appling and the one off South Parkway.
Well, thank you, Earl. Thank your sponsor for sponsoring this for us. It was very nice of them to do this.
Well, I do thank them every time we do the show, because everybody talks about wanting to help the restaurants, but not that many people do. I mean, they come in and they maybe leave a $5 extra than they would before, but getting lots of people and keeping them coming in the door is what's going to keep you going.
Well, that's true. A lot of people are still afraid to eat out. It's just the way it is nowadays.
But
the business is up, so it's helping us to stay in business.
Well, we'll keep mentioning you, and this will stay up on my Facebook page, and we'll share it to yours so people can get the tour. And once they see your food again, they'll be back in. Everybody's sick of eating that frozen pizza from the store. Well, thank you, sir. Merry Christmas to you, and tell all your staff Merry Christmas as well.
Thank you. Merry Christmas to you also.
You're sure welcome.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Jerry Coletta, the guy. I mean, he's an institution as well. I mean, you know, he's just been around forever. And I want to thank Southern Security Federal Credit Union for sponsoring this segment of My Favorite Restaurant. And certainly the folks at Coletta's are one of the favorite restaurants here in Memphis. Southern Security's got 5 locations, and they love the restaurant business. They take care of a lot of restaurants and help the young people get their first credit card, maybe their first car, then their first house. And they're not a bank, but you have to join. I think they put like 50 or 100 bucks in, and that takes care of it. And you're now an owner of a credit union. That's what all the people there that join are. They're part owners, and they treat you that way. So support them, and we'll have another great restaurant on tomorrow. And in the meantime, call in a big order, big strike, airstrike at Coletta's, and go in and pick up an order to go, go in and eat. I was at Bass Pro earlier today. The parking lot was full. The place was full. I mean, there are people walking all over the place. I was at Costco the other day, full. Don't be afraid to go to a restaurant. They're set, we get the tables separated. Everybody stays 6 feet apart. The same food, and I promise you, they're taking care of it. Everybody's masked up and wearing gloves in the kitchen, and so it's safe. I got no problem with it. We get something every single day from some restaurant here in town, and go eat it. I've eaten at several here in the last couple of weeks, so just keep supporting them, because this is, they've been hit extraordinarily hard. There's other people that really haven't been phased at all. They moved all their employees home. They're operating from homes, and they just keep on going. And restaurants have poor people in New York and out of California, I mean, they've totally shut them down. Said, you can keep your outside venue open, but you can't let anybody inside. When tracing these back to the origin of the virus, and for people that have been tested positive, less than 1% are being traced back to a restaurant. Most of them, the number one place they get it is home. And what do? They tell you to stay home. But just keep washing your hands, keep your mask on, and eat out, eat local. And we'll see you tomorrow. Have a great evening.